In this video, we're going to finish our factoring special case worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free Algebra 1 worksheet. Remembering our special cases are a squared minus b squared, a squared minus 2ab plus b squared, and a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. And number 17, we have a squared minus b squared. So the factors are going to be a plus b and a minus b. A squared in this case is 49x squared, and b squared is 100. Taking the square root of a squared and the square root of 49x squared, since when I take the square root of one side of my equation, I must also do the same to the other. Square root of a squared is a, and the square root of 49x squared is 7x. And for my next equation, when I take the square root of both sides, I'll get that b is equal to 10. So I'm going to plug 7x in for a and 10 in for b and my factors. So I'll have 7x plus 10 times 7x minus 10. And if you want to double check, feel free to FOIL this out. Multiplying 7x to 7x, 7x to 10, 10 to 7x, and then 10 to 10, remembering that that's subtracted. And you will get 49x squared minus 100. On to 18, we have a squared minus b squared. So that's going to be a plus b and a minus b as the factors. A squared is 1, and b squared is r squared. So if I take the square root of a squared and the square root of 1, I'll get that a is equal to 1. If I take the square root of b squared and the square root of r squared, I'll get that b is equal to r. Plugging 1 in for a and r in for b, I'll get 1 plus r times 1 minus r. That's my solution in number 18. Moving on to number 19, we do not yet have a squared minus b squared, but we will get there if we just pull out a p from each term. And we can not just pull out a p, but we can pull out a 10p, since 10p goes into 10p cubed, and 10p goes into 1960p. So if I take out 10p, I'll be left with p squared minus 196. Since 10p times p squared is 10p cubed, and 10p times 196 is 1960p. Now I have my a squared minus b squared. So that's going to equal a plus b times a minus b. However, we need to keep track of this 10p. So 10p will be multiplied to the factors of p squared minus 196. So in this case, my a squared is p squared, and my b squared is 196. Taking the square root of a squared and p squared, I'll get that a is equal to p, and taking the square root of b squared and 196, I'll get that b is equal to 14, since 14 squared is 196. So now I'll plug p and 14 in for a and b. 10p times p plus 14 times p minus 14. That is the solution in number 19. In number 20, I can pull out 7b squared from each of the terms. Since 7 goes into both 343 and 7 evenly, and b squared goes into b squared, and b squared goes into b to the fourth. So taking out a 7b squared, 343 divided by 7 is 49. So 49 times 7b squared is 343b squared. And then 7b squared times b squared is 7b to the fourth. So now I have a squared minus b squared, which is a plus b times a minus b. Now, not to get the b in our polynomial confused with the b in the formula, but since b squared is equal to b squared, the square root of both of those will be b. So b is equal to b, so I can just leave b in since it's represented by b. I just need to figure out a. And a squared is equal to 49. So if I take the square root of a squared and the square root of 49, I get that a is equal to 7. So since b is equal to b and a is equal to 7, I'll plug each of those into the formula.
However, remember, a plus b times a minus b will be the factors of 49 minus b squared. So I need to multiply those factors by 7b squared in order to get the factors of my original polynomial. So 7b squared times a plus b, 7 plus b, times a minus b, 7 minus b. So my solution in number 20 is 7b squared times 7b times 7 minus b. And number 21, 9 goes into 81 evenly, and it also goes into 900 evenly. So I'll pull out a 9 from each of those terms. And v squared goes into v squared, and v squared goes into v to the fourth. So I'll pull out a 9v squared. So 9v squared times 9v squared equals 81v to the fourth. And 9v squared times 100 equals 900v squared. So I have my a squared minus b squared. That's going to give me a plus b times a minus b. However, those are the factors of the polynomial 9v squared minus 100. So I'm going to need to multiply that by 9b squared to get the factors of 81b to the fourth minus 900b squared. A squared in this case is 9b squared, and b squared is 100. Square root of a squared and the square root of 9b squared will give me that a is equal to 3b. The square root of b squared and the square root of 100 will give me that b is equal to 10. So I'll have 9b squared times 3v plus 10 times 3v minus 10. That is my solution in number 21. And lastly on this worksheet, number 22. In each of these terms, I can pull out an m squared. I can also pull out an 8. So I'll have 8m squared that I pull out. 8 goes into 225 times, an m squared times m squared is m to the fourth. So 8m squared times 25m squared is 200m to the fourth. And I'm adding that 8m squared times what will give me 80m cubed? That will be 10m. Since 8 times 10 is 80 and m squared times m is m to the third. And then lastly, 8m squared times 1 is 8m squared. So I have a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. That's going to equal a plus b squared. However, the factors of that polynomial will need to get multiplied by 8m squared in order to get the factors of our original polynomial. So a squared is equal to 25m squared, and b squared is equal to 1. The square root of a squared and the square root of 25m squared will give us that a is equal to 5m. The square root of b squared equal to the square root of 1 will give us that b is equal to 1. So now I can plug b and a into my formula. So I'll get 8m squared times 5m plus 1 squared. And that is the final solution on this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. Subscribe and like this video. And if you found this video very helpful, feel free to share it along.